Several lawyers warn of a constitutional crisis if the Supreme Court halts the proclamation of the winner of the presidential race in response to the disqualification cases against presumptive president Bongbong Marcos. To avoid this, they see two possible scenarios playing out.
Moot and academic na to kasi nagkaroon na tayo ng election. May 31 million persons na nabumoto kay Bongbong Marcos. Tapos, kapag sasabihin, kapag i-open pa yung issue na to, ano pang silbi niya? E, binoto na nga siya ng mga tao.
The way that I see it, no, it can either be dismissed by the Supreme Court for being moot and academic, or the Supreme Court will rather rule that it is a political question that is out of the hands of the court.
But for the former president of the Philippine Bar Association, a popular vote cannot erase the irregularities or flaws in a candidate's qualifications, should there be any found.
Basta pag sinabi ng Supreme Court na he's not qualified, then he's not qualified, and therefore his election would be nullified ab initio. It is incumbent for the Supreme Court right now to expedite its resolution of these petitions so that yung anxiety ng mga tao, totoong qualified yung candidate, eh, dapat we settle our minds that ito na ang ating presidente.
Several groups are seeking to either disqualify or cancel the certificate of candidacy of Marcos on the basis of his 1995 tax conviction.
The Philippine Commission on Elections brushing off the report of the International Observer Mission, which said the May 9 polls failed to meet the criteria for free and fair elections. The COMELEC emphasizes that around 300 other international observers, including the U.S., affirmed the integrity of the recently held national elections. COMELEC adding that the IOC has no legal personality as it is not an accredited observer. But the poll body says it will continue to probe supposed incidents of vote buying, which are included in the report of the IOM.
Kahit na yan ay nanalo na sa isang issue ng disqualification, halimbawa, kandidato for mayor na disqualified dahil sa issue ng vote buying, na determine namin talaga na involved sa vote buying, tatanggalin namin yung mayor at ang makakaupo ay ang vice mayor.
The COMELEC is also investigating a viral video which showed ballot boxes laying around a vacant lot in Cavite. Commissioner George Garcia claims the ballots found in the area were used during the testing of the machines before the elections.
Hindi po ito mga balota, hindi po ito mga original na balota. Ito po ay mga training ballots, meaning yung mga balota na ginamit natin nung tayo ay nagte-training at the same time nagpa-final testing and sealing at mga ilang dokumento, pero hindi po ito mga original na balota o wala rin ito yung mga election returns na tinatawag. Ngayon po, ang inaalam na lang namin ay kung bakit ba naman nadala nung F2 Logistics o nung aming pong provider, kung bakit nadala mula sa Tondo papunta doon sa Cavite at bakit naandun lang sa isang tabi.
Hundreds of ballot boxes containing the votes for president and vice president have arrived at the House of Representatives. Our correspondent Ana Cerezo is there, and she joins us live for more details on the scheduled canvassing of votes. Ana, good morning. What more can you tell us?
Good morning, Mike. Congress is gearing up for the canvassing of votes for the country's next president and vice president. Today's preparations kicked off with a safe transfer of over 600 ballot boxes from the Senate to the House of Representatives this morning. The documents arrived shortly before 5 a.m. Officials began loading the ballot boxes past midnight. They first loaded the certificates of canvass. Officials distributed the 167 ballot boxes containing the said documents into two trucks. Meanwhile, the 441 ballot boxes containing election returns was divided into five trucks. According to the Sergeant at Arms, the convoy to the House of Representatives consisted of 19 vehicles deployed by AFP, which included two armored vehicles as well as eight motorcycle escorts and a mobile patrol from PNP. Based on the latest tally, Mike, the Senate has received 90.17% or 156 out of the 173 certificates of canvass. The Senate will continue receiving the remaining COCs from areas in Mindanao and diplomatic Philippine posts on Tuesday, May 24. Senate Senators and congressmen are also scheduled on the 24th to convene and begin canvassing the votes for the next president and vice president of the Philippines. Mike, back to you.
And so officially, the canvassing will start tomorrow, May 24th. Have you been hearing talks about the possibility of, say, any TRO being issued by the Supreme Court? Does the Senate and the House of Representatives have any contingency plans if that takes if that happens?
Mike, for now, they're still waiting for, as we can see, that they're still waiting for the announcement of the TRO. But as they've mentioned, that they don't see it happening, but if ever it does, the Senate will, they don't see that there's any possibility. For now, they're hoping that there won't be a possibility for the president and the vice president to be delayed. But Mike, we'll have to get back to you on what exactly their plan is. But they're saying as much as possible, they do not want to delay it beyond June 30th, Mike.
All right. Thanks a lot for that update. Ana Cerezo.